Figure. I never had the biggest soft spot for Transformers Prime Deluxe figures, truly, but this is probably one of the best ones. Now, if you don't know, a bunch of Transformers Prime characters came out as Warrior Class, and, Transformers Prime figures never went to Leader Class, ever. Probably, like, figures around that size, but never truly a Leader Class. So, but the Deluxe Class figures here are just... they're good. Not even as good as the Voyager class figures, but they're good. So this figure was first released in 2012 at the BotCon as a Big Bat Toy Store exclusive. I want the red version, but I feel a lot better having this more rare version of Knockout. So, something I didn't do with the other figures is articulation. I don't think I did this in the review with Thundertron. So, let's get to articulation. His leg can move up this far. Now, and it can go this way. Can go this way. Can bend. Can also twist at the thigh. Then at the foot, he can move it up and around. And then, nothing at the waist. I don't think Prime figures ever had waist articulation to begin with. Then, his arm can move. It can twist. It has a bicep joint right here. Then, also has another joint supported by the wheel. You can use that. It kind of acts like a butterfly joint. I'm not going to say it is, though. Then, it can bend. Then, God, it's so hard trying to record around the camera. Then his hand can bend that. Same with that hand. Then his head is on a ball joint, I think. Yeah, that's his articulation. Now I do have some other Prime figures with me here. I don't have a bunch of the Prime Voyagers. I think like three. I haven't really counted. I'm supposed to be buying a Transformers original Megatron, Dark Gaia Megatron, soon. Just wait to see that one in this motion instead of Sharkticon Megatron. But here he is compared to his ultimate companion, Bumblebee. And they scale up good. I'm still not the biggest fan of the Bumblebee color scheme that they went for. I wish they would have went for like probably like an orangish color for the Dark Energy on Bumblebee, or even like the same color scheme as him, but if you don't know us, so, okay. Then we have Bulkhead, which is going to be in a future review. It's a disappointing figure. I bought it basically because it was only $11. So. Last but not least, you have to do this. If you have to have Knockout, you have to have at least one of his companions, Megatron. See how he scales there with his past boss. So yeah. Overall, Knockout's not a bad figure. Now, the deco of this guy, he's supposed to look like Lockdown, his color scheme. I feel like he's more supposed to be like a Constructicon, but people have been saying it's Lockdown, and Lockdown seems like the more efficient, probably even official answer. So let's go ahead and get transformation. So first, you want to start off with the feet here. You want to twist around his foot. And if you can see that, it's a little tab. Same with the red Knockout. plug that his foot in there. Then you want to twist that around. Second foot, same as the first. Just want to twist that. Go around. Bam. His feet should be looking like this. Very like some of those deluxe figures back from the day, with their legs and look right. Reminds me of that. Next, you want to go ahead and go to the arm. I never transformed these by the instructions, so I may be a little off how you transform. You're going to open that. Now you want to keep that open. Second arm, same as the first. Do that. You should have this overall. Let me move my light. Okay. Sorry, I have a long sleeve on. Now, you're going to now move his head into his chest. Then, you're going to untab these from the back of the sides of him. Now, you want to get his head and put it under there. Your figure should look like a big mess now. And next, his chest can go down. Now you want to just flip that inside out. Second verse, same as the first. That's the thing I gotta say about these Prime figures. The transformations were never easy. So, next, you want to get him under there. And now, a part that I always get confused on is how to get his arms right there. So, next, you want to just flip that around. Right there. Then, second verse, same as the first. I'm not trying to make him look perfect right now. And thing is, these Prime figures are really hard to transform. Sometimes it can end up to like breaking a joint. Almost happened with Sharpticon Megatron once with me. So the arm, right there, you should see under it. That should be there. And then, I guess you can flip that around. Darn. These arms have always been a challenge for me. Especially trying to get these. The arms are like, alright, kind of finally. The Prime figures' arms were the main goal to get rid of. Like, legs are easy to get rid of by either transforming into the trunk, or as with a lot of Leader Awesome Primes, having being a part of the front. And now, you want to put his feet, tuck him in. This figure is so compact when he's transformed. God. So you want to get his leg right there. Same with this leg. You want to get this leg and transform. So, God, no. I'll be back with comparisons. My figure transformed already, thank God. And it's another Transformers Prime figure. And here he is compared to Deluxe Bumblebee. As you can see here, Bumblebee is actually bigger than him in car mode, which is always surprising to me because Knockout is such a face shifter, like a transformer. He can transform. He can be so tall. The figure's about this tall, but it transforms. It's one of the smallest Transformers Prime figures there is. So, here's a side-to-side comparison. As you can see, very cool. I like Bumblebee's tires better. So, yeah. And now back to the vehicle itself. So, if you look at his windshield, it's really reflective. I don't know if the original was made out of this translucent plastic. It goes around the whole entire car besides the back, which there should be some. And it looks really nice, especially for stop motion reasons. It like shines and reflects off. And then under, of course, very confusing underside. Compared to Bumblebee, their undersides are not much really that different. Besides that his crotch is way up here and his crotch is way down there. And then their legs are do kind of the same thing, especially during transformation. Their arms not at all. So I felt like the Bumblebee was a little bit more of a shell former. Not that much, but just a little bit of a shell former. And then we have the most disappointing figure I ever saw in my whole entire life compared to him. Not in car vehicle mode. That is going to be in a review soon. This thing. Bulkhead. Deluxe. This figure's so rare now, but no one wants him anyway. But here he is compared to Knockout. They have almost the same green. It's just like they got Bulkhead's green and made it translucent. Either I'm just colorblind, but yeah. But anyway, Knockout is a pretty good figure. Is he worth the $7? Yes. Especially for a cheap price of $7. That's amazing. Now, I hope you comment, like, and subscribe. Beware, there will be more Transformers Prime figure reviews. And we're getting pretty close to reviewing Bumblebee now. Well, already pretty much there. Expect a review on Megatron, Transformers Prime Optimus Prime, and some other Transformers Prime figures. Prime out. Why are you still here? Click on another video. There's more, I promise. Go now. I'd warned you. Knockout! Come on. Wreck them all. Why are you still here? Click some more videos. Go to my channel and click some more. You're asking for it. You are definitely asked for it. I said, go to another video. Click right now. Go. I swear there's one on the side. I'm done. I'm giving up. Click on another video!